How dare the man?
I think the tribal women are a little better off than the rest of the mainland women.
All right, we have always heard about the woman empowerment, but do we actually understand what is woman empowerment? Well, I cannot talk about the woman from other state because this video is basically on the perspective of my state, Arunachal Pradesh. Well, I don't know if I'm right or wrong, but for me, woman empowerment refers to making the woman more powerful enough to make them capable of deciding for themselves. So, do the women in our state are capable enough to decide for themselves, or they are bounded by the shackles of customary laws prevailing in our indigenous communities? Anyway, hello and welcome back to my channel. This is me, Jon Pebi Tato, and you are watching JPT Videos for You. So today in this video, I will be talking about the women empowerment, which I came to know from the event called the Catalyst of Courage, which was organized by Ngurang Learning Institute at Itanagar. So keep watching the video till the end. Alright, before moving ahead to the video, let me tell you something about the Catalyst of Courage 2.0. The Catalyst of Courage 2.0 was organized by Ngurang Learning Institute, and it basically aims to discover the unsung heroes of Arunachal Pradesh. Like there is a hero in the movie, so they came up with heroes. Hero, heroes. So heroes basically, it denotes the women folks. The Ngurang Learning Institute is one of the renowned emerging non-profit institute based in Nirjuli, founded and co-founded by the Ngurang sisters. Like we heard about Tetsuo sisters from Nagaland, I think we have our own sisters too, the Ngurang sisters. Well, in 21st century, while other young girls are busy in something else, these Ngurang sisters, namely Ngurang Meena and Ngurang Reena, they came forward, they struggled and established an institute for youths and for the deprived women section. And it is really commendable. Bahut mehnat lagta hai, bahut. And from my side, a huge salute to both the sisters. You have done very well. Catalyst of Courage organized by Ngurang sisters was very effective, very much. Well, I want to say something to the girls. Ab log itna women empowerment, itna girls ko equal right milna chahiye, ye wo baat karta hai na. Lekin jab itna acha se women's ke liye, aap log ke liye event organize karta hai, to aap log kyun nahi aate? I was expecting lots of girls, like they would be present during the event. Lekin hum jab gaya tha, kya hua? Khali khali. So I would suggest the girls and young girls and especially youths who are studying or somewhere else, please do support this kind of event. It is for you. It is for the women's section. It is for the girls. It is for the future ahead. Anyway, let's move ahead. Why the woman empowerment is needed and what is the importance of it? First, the women's section feels that there is a kind of inequality and vulnerability of the women in all spheres of life. So that is the reason the women empowerment is needed. Every woman, be it from every section of society, needs to be empowered in every walk of their life. Without the active participation of women, establishment of new social order may not be a successful one, because women constitute half of the population. Women should realize that they have constitutional rights to quality health care, economic security, and access to education and political power. So what could be the advantage of women being empowered? Well, if one woman is empowered, her next generation will be empowered by her. If a woman is empowered, she don't have to be a burden for anyone, not even for her husband or father or anyone. She will be independent and strong. And yes, if the woman is empowered, her family becomes stronger because of both working hands. Aur waise bhi aajkal to aurat log hi zyada kaam kar rahe hain na. Anyway, there are lots of advantages for the woman being empowered. If you have any more ideas, please do let me know in the comment section below.
In 2000, the Arunachal Pradesh Land Settlement and Records Act was legislated, and the preamble of the bill had said that this bill was to facilitate economic growth in Arunachal Pradesh. And it also, of course, mentioned that the management of land in Arunachal would be as per the customary laws. I would begin by saying, how dare, you know, how dare the man still in this, you know, in 21st century, in 2019,
still think that they can get away, you know, by marrying 2-3 wives without the consent of the first wife. How dare they look at the, I fail to understand, you know, this is, I'm still trying, this is an effort, my small, this piece of paper is an effort at my understanding, you know, the temerity, the audacity of not every man, but many men who think and who take it as their entitlement that they can and they should be, they think they should be allowed, you know, with full honor and justice and grace and, you know, everything, that they should be allowed to marry more than one woman, you know.
A lot of social media troll on women activists, on women who put up this, you know, contextually, a practice customary, you know, which is beautiful in nature. So I've traveled like 24 countries today. When I go back to talk at different forum, matrilineal is very unique by itself. We are not matriarchal. Having, giving the surname to our mother is very unique when you go back into gender rights in today's perspective. It has good, it's good element. If you're talking about the lineage through the mother, and there's no illegitimate child in the society, it's a beautiful concept when it comes to women's rights and gender practices.
I think the tribal women are a little better off than the rest of the mainland women. If I am, you know, to say so, I may be wrong, but that's my observation. But here in Arunachal, when we talk about codifying the customary law, like my friend has said, even if you enact a law, you know, legalizing or codifying the entire customary law, until unless you are ready, because we have so much of penal codes, acts, which are still in the society. We say theft is a crime, murder is a crime, you know, and a lot of other things, but still the society has those kind of menace. So then when he says, we have to change from here.
If the land management will continue to be as per the customary laws, where the women of Arunachal, especially the tribal women of Arunachal, cannot inherit landed properties from natal families, from parental families, how do we propose to include the women in the economic growth process?
We are talking about polygamy, and since we are talking about customary law, so polygamy is one subject which is, I won't say it is very dear, but which is very conflicting and which is affecting, I think, almost, I have case studies in my immediate family, extended family, relatives, you know, everywhere, left, right and center I see. And I don't see any way out. So I fail to understand this. To aadmi to aadmi, men are men. I'll not let go of the man by saying men are men. You know? But I'm just saying this sentence. We are tired of the man doing that. But the latest fad, the latest joke, which is very saddening and unfortunate, is that our own women, our own young girls, and you know, much educated, much well-placed in, you know, they are resorting to, they show no remorse, no regret, no shame, nothing in becoming second, third, fourth wife of much married man.
Our society did not evolve. You know, somebody very lightly said, actually our people jump from a tree and enter into a car. You know, that was the kind of observations people are making, our own people said, because we have to see the evolutions of the civilizations, then only things will get into your mind, and you know how you behave in a civilized society, the what kind of thing. Then only, you know, we see that, you know, this kind of issues, this kind of discussions, this kind of activist would not come up in the society. So I want to see an Arunachal when there will be no women right activist, when there will be no need of a women commission. That is the time when we will say that yes, Arunachal is not gender biased and there's a parity between the male and the female.
our societies mostly are patrilocal, you know, families, where after marriage the girls have to move out to the husband's village or husband's family village. She's dislocated from her parental village. So that was the traditional reason they give us, that daughters were not given landed property because she could not have taken her share of, you know, land to her husband's place. So she has always been inheriting the movable properties like ornaments and antiques.
So we have seen the need, the importance and advantages of the women empowerment. We have also watched the panel discussions from the prominent women. So now the question is our woman really empowered? Has our woman been able to come out from the able system existing in our customary laws? Well, protecting and safeguarding our culture and tradition and our customary laws is okay, well and good. But can we eliminate those able system existing in our tradition and culture or in our customary laws and take the good one with us? In that way, we can preserve our society and also give a ray of hope for our women section. Chalo, anyway, this was all for today. I just wanted to highlight the women empowerment. For a betterment of our society, we must also give an equal status to our women folks. And I also want to remind the women folks key, we men are not dominating you. And if we are dominating, please forgive us. And to the men section, please do not dominate the girls. And I think we are not dominating. I think these days, women are at par with the men. So, see you again in the next video. Bye-bye.